please subscribe to our YouTube channel Van Finn Multibaggers and press the bell icon to see the latest updates and videos. Van Finn, discover opportunities, create wealth.
International, the counter has gained over 21% in the last 1 month itself. What are the factors contributing to these healthy gains? Let's ask the management. Joining us on the phone line is Managing Director and CEO Vimal Kejriwal. Good morning, Mr. Kejriwal, and thank you for giving us your time. I believe you've guided for a 10 to 15% revenue growth guidance for FY18, but you also have a strong L1 pipeline. So if you could tell us how the order inflow momentum has been for the fourth quarter, and what do you expect to do in terms of top line growth in FY19 then?
So if you look at our order book, we had announced an orders of almost 2000 crores along with our Q3 results. So with that 2000 and odd, our order intake for the year has been 11,300 crores. And our order book as of now is around 17,100 crores plus an L1 of close to 4,000. So if you add that to, you're almost at 21,000 crores, which is why we feel that, you know, for the year, we should be growing around 10 to 15%. And again, we should have a better growth, you know, for FY19.
So the cables business, I believe, was impacted in the second and third quarter on account of that 28% GST, which was then brought down to 18%. So would that help bump up the cable business revenues in Q4, and fair to expect a single digit growth at least in the cables business?
I don't think we'll have a single digit growth in cable business because what's happened was that 28% was a big dampener. The second problem what we are running onto the revenue part on the cable is the change in the product mix. See, with the LME going up, the copper prices are $7,000 and aluminium is $2,200. So we are seeing a marked shift among customers moving in from copper cables into aluminium cables. So although we are doing a large volume increase, but in terms of value, because of the change in the customer preferences, the overall revenues are not growing significantly.
Right. So also, you have been scaling up your new business verticals of railways and civil construction. So what is the kind of quarterly run rate that you're expecting to see in both these businesses going forward into FY19?
Okay, so let me just talk about railways first. Railways, over the last 3 years, we have doubled our revenues every year, 200 crores. Last year, we did 400. This year, we'll probably do between 750 and 800 crores. And next year, we have been talking about doing around 1500 crores an order. So every year, we are doubling our business. Out of the 11,300 crores of order intake this year, almost 2600 crores have come in from railways. So railways, clearly, we are very bullish. And if you sort of divide the numbers, will be 300, 400 crores per quarter should be coming in from railways now. Civil is a new business which we got into, where we build factories and residential buildings associated with the factories, etc. We started this business this year. We have an order book of close to 500 crores. This year, we should do a revenue of 150 crores and out. Next year, probably we'll do 400 or 500 crores of revenue in our civil business.
All right. So what are the margins in the new orders like? Are they higher than the average margins in your order backlog, your book?
I'll not say that the margins are somewhere around the range of 10% or something. The reason why we've been looking at an uptick in the margin has been that we have been closing all our old orders which were at a lower margins or legacy orders. And since those have been going out of our system, we have been able to, you know, improve our margins for the last few quarters consistently.
The net working capital as on 31st December had witnessed some increase on account of delay in collections from Saudi Arabia. Has that situation improved?
So let me put it this way. As on March, we had a net working capital of around 105, 107 days or something like that. It's gone up to around 140 days. We do expect that it should go back to probably 105, 110 days by March end. We've had a significant amount of collection since 31st December. I don't have the exact amount. I think around 500 crores in order have already come in from Saudi. There were some other payments which were delayed beyond, you know, which were to come in December, which have come in now. I think we are pretty comfortable with what our net working capital and borrowing numbers, and we should probably be back to our March 17 levels.
Mr. Kejriwal, good morning. There is one, there is a note which speaks about how a JV between State Utilities and Power Grid Corporation could provide a host of opportunities for the industry at large. Can you explain to us how would these opportunities come about, and what would be KEC's role out here? What is it that you would like to garner from these opportunities as and when they come about?
See, this JV to me is coming out of two reasons. One is because Power Grid is not getting jobs on nomination basis, and they have to, you know, fight on the other private players. Their share has been gradually going down. So obviously Power Grid wants to maintain its 25,000 crore of capex. And one of the ways they have found out is that they are now doing joint ventures with Bihar. There was a joint venture on card with UP, Jharkhand. So what the JVs do is that they tender out the T&D projects in these states, which normally earlier have been, you know, sort of a bit difficult for these states because people were not very keen to go and do work in Bihar or UP, considering the financial state affairs of those SEBs. Now with Power Grid being a majority partner there and Power Grid running the project execution, it becomes a much more bankable proposal for, you know, EPC players. I think that's where we are looking at it. We are already seeing some tenders coming out in Bihar. I think UP there is some issues going on, so that JV is still not in place. I think Jharkhand is already in place, if I'm not mistaken. So this is a new opportunity where we can sort of recoup the reduction in the Power Grid order book.
Would the nature of these orders be, or would the sizes of these orders be very large, Mr. Kejriwal?
We have not seen the big orders coming out, but the capex planning for, you know, I don't have the numbers, but for Bihar and UP, there will be larger orders coming out, definitely.
Okay.
See, one thing which I would like to say is that when you look at orders coming out of state, somewhere we have an impression that the orders are small in size, but that's not correct. Some of the orders which we have got from some of the SEBs from Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, are actually much bigger than the orders which we get from Power Grid, because these orders are lump sum orders which include all the supplies, everything, whereas Power Grid prefers to split jobs. So the value of these orders can be very large.
Okay, so you may not have seen a large order, but there is an outside chance of large orders coming in for the industry. Whether KEC gets a piece of that remains to be seen. But is there
absolutely.
Is there any number that you can give us a sense of? I mean, what would constitute a large order to your mind, coming out of a JV between Power Grid and a state utility?
To me, any order, let's say about 400, 500 crores is a large order for an SEB.
Okay. 400-500 crores.
All right. And sir, over the past few quarters, the promoter stake has been slowly inching up. Any plans to raise it further from that 51% level?
To me, I don't think it's been inching up. I think the last transaction which was reported was, as far as I know, it was an interstate transfer. For some reason, it got reported as a promoter hiking the stake. So at least the last transaction was not a hike. That was an interstate transfer.
Right, Mr. Kejriwal, thank you very much for joining us and giving us your time. So that was the management of KEC International, betting big on the railways business, and also saying that their net working capital has improved significantly and has come down on account of higher collections that they have seen December onwards.